visit us. If you dare, we guarantee that you'll be scared.
Chocolate bars here in Macaulay Co. We find out how parents and the little ones cope with ghost stories, terrifying tours, haunted houses and the like. Yesterday we heard how Ali Campbell's children Evie and Lachlan gone with a scary movie, and today Macaulay Co reporter and mum of three Vicky Johnson joins us to talk about her family's scary experience. Morning Vicky.
Good morning.
How are you?
I'm very well, thank you.
Did you sleep well?
Well as one can, living in a house with my three children.
Any night visitors?
It's just Dylan chapping out the door at 3:15 this morning to tell him he couldn't sleep.
He couldn't sleep because?
Well, he just couldn't sleep. However, he has had to spend a couple of nights in my room since our scary experience and beside Mummy.
What did you do, Vicky?
Well, we went on a ghost walk round about the town of Paisley, which we did that on Sunday night. Started at 6:30, so it was suitably dark enough. You know, by that time, to start walking around about the time. So we visited all the... It was fantastic, actually, because it gave a lot of the history of the town, which I'd heard, you know, bits and pieces of throughout the years, but it took you to all the wee spots where, you know, all the bodies were taken during the plague and all that kind of thing. So it was great for the kids and for the adults.
My goodness. Now, are they easily scared, your children? Have they been scared of things in the past?
I wouldn't say they're terribly easily frightened. I'm quite strict about films that they watch and things like that. I wouldn't have them watching, you know, like films that were far too old for them. We did, however, sit down to watch The Gremlins one night. Forgot how gruesome it could be at some point, so we had to put it off because Charlotte was a bit frightened, but that was going back a few years now. So that they're not terribly easily frightened. Charlotte is a thrill seeker. You know, she likes roller coasters, but that's different from being frightened, I suppose.
Okay, had you any apprehensions about taking them on this tour?
No, because they were quite excited, actually. They were really looking forward to it, so I wasn't worried about taking them on it.
Righty-ho. Well, Vicky, you took along one of the recorders to the tour, so let's have a listen to the family trip.
He's called me Vicky the Victim, so that's a wee bit scary. What do you think, Charlotte?
Creepy.
Are you scared yet?
No.
Are you scared yet, Dylan?
No, and I won't be.
Okay. The ghost walk has just started. We've met two of Charlotte's friends, Breeze and Ellie, who are both the same age as Charlotte. We're on the way to the first location, which is called Dead Man's Alley, and we'll find out what happens when we get there. Dylan, we're at Dead Man's Alley. Are you frightened?
No.
Why are you not frightened?
Because it's some just silly old stories.
Oh, well, we'll see.
Sometimes people are talking.
Scary.
You were both scared?
Yeah.
Maybe this ghost walk's going to turn out to be scary after all. Dylan, are you a wee bit frightened now?
To be honest, a little tiny bit.
Being followed by the Grim Reaper and he's ringing his bell. He's coming for me. I think I'm done for. We're a good way through the ghost walk now. Dylan, what do you think?
I think I'm a bit scared now.
Sometimes you might see them on the...
There!
Charlotte, we're just about to walk into the place where the people were executed in Paisley. Are you frightened?
Yes.
You are? Why are you frightened?
Because it's dead people. I'm very scared.
It's very dark.
Please,
what's happening?
John Lindsay.
He looks like Lindsay Gillis.
I was the farmer.
The ghost walk's finished now. What do we think of it, guys? Was it scary?
A little bit. Some of it was scary. Some of it wasn't really.
And Dylan, you're the man of the crowd. What did you think? Was it scary?
A wee bit. That's where people jumped out unexpectedly. But the bit where the axe murderer jumped out, I thought was was actually quite funny.
Well, there you have it. Mixed reviews for the Ghost Walk. Kids were scared, but most of all, they thoroughly enjoyed it, and I think that's what's most important.
I like the confidence in Dylan at the very start. Are you scared? No, and I won't be. I don't think that's the kind of change in emotion you're treated to if you ever watch a full episode of Deal or No Deal, when you see them go from confidence to despair in less than an hour. So he did admit that he was a wee bit scared towards the end, and then a sleepless night afterwards. So obviously he was thinking about what was going on, but did you labour the point that ghosts, you know, ghosts, if they wouldn't harm you when you were alive, they wouldn't harm you when they're dead, which is the sort of line that we used to get when we were wee and terrified?
No, I'd just let them be frightened. That's the whole point. I mean, they might come and get you. I mean, Dylan was very, you know, giving it bravado. No, I'm not frightened, but he was like a limpet. You know, he was clinging on to Scott or me at all times. And the ghost walk was great because they had people jumping out of corridors and closes, and their faces were all painted. But I think it was more the stories that they were telling rather than the sort of actual physical beings of the people being there. You know, it was the stories about how people were hung and people fell from church spires and you were standing on the spot where they died. And that's where you've seen the kids' faces changing and thinking, oh, wait a wee minute.
Well, I suppose the greater the history of the location, the better the ghost walk is going to be, you know, which is why Edinburgh is so popular. But Paisley has, you know, will have great claims to historical ghost stories as well. Now, this will be a busy week for the ghost walks, I would think, Vicky.
Yeah, well, I would think so. I think this particular one only runs for 3 Sundays
right.
of the year, which I think this one might, the forthcoming Sunday is maybe the last Sunday. But as I say, it's absolutely fascinating facts that I never knew, and it's actually kind of made me think, do you know what, I'm going to go home and find out a wee bit more about that.
Yeah.
And I think it made the kids think a lot about the way life was in the past. So we're talking about the old toll booth where children were locked up for 8 days for stealing bread and things, you know, and that's always a good threat to bring back to the kids.
Yes, that's
you've got
8 days for bread. Finally, Vicky, have you got the costumes ready for Halloween yet?
Fred, I've been so lax this year. Last night was just a wee run in the supermarket to grab some bits and pieces for Dylan. Charlotte wants to go as a cat playing a guitar. Yeah, I don't know why that is. And Lucy's just going all out on the freaky face paint. So,
right. And Dylan?
He's going as a kind of shop-bought demon type thing. So,
right.
You know, that's fine because we've got the school disco tonight.
Oh, nice one. Oh, well, thank you very much to you and to the kids as well. And the friends along with them too, so thank them for us too, Vicky.
Come visit us if you dare. We guarantee that you'll be scared.